I've been spelunking around iOS 18, and turns out we get a bunch of new shortcuts actions. From being able to add entries to the journal through shortcuts, built-in toggle action for HomeKit devices, a bunch of helpful actions for managing your shortcuts, and better organization for lots of actions. Now keep in mind, I'm running iOS 18.1 Dev Beta 2, and so you won't see these actions in older operating systems, but they should be coming soon. First up are new actions for the built-in Apple Journal. I've been using it since it launched in iOS 17, and if you search for Journal now in Shortcuts, we have three new actions. You can create an audio entry, create a new text entry, and search your entries. So I use the search entries action here, and you can see this is going to ask for a prompt, so I can run this shortcut. It'll say, what do you want to search for? We recently went to New York City, and I know I have some journal entries from that, so I'll hit done. Of course, you have to authenticate for the journal app, and here it pulled up all the journal entries with that search term. Should make it a little easier to find journal entries that you're looking for. And you can also create new journal entries using the built-in actions. Here I have the create journal entry action, and I actually started with a dictate text. This way I can just speak to the shortcut, it'll transcribe that text, and add it as an entry. Then the action has all these other options, like adding the location, which you can set to your current location, so when you create the journal entry, it will be that, or you can have this ask every time. You can pull in media from different sources. Right now it just kind of opens the Files app, but if you tap and hold on that plus button, you can choose to ask each time, choose specific photos you might want to attach, or even get media from the shortcut input. So if you want to share a photo from your photo library and automatically attach it to a journal entry. You can name the location, even mark this entry as bookmarked. I chose current date for the journal entry, and it's going to open the entry when run. So if I run the shortcut, made a great video about shortcuts today, especially the new actions in iOS 18. I'll hit stop, it transcribes that text, and it's going to create that journal entry. It's asking me for the title. I'll hit done, and it's going to go over to the journal app, and it attached that location that I predetermined. It has today's date, and I get the title and text right there. We'll definitely be using these to quickly add entries from different shortcuts. Next, we have a new built-in toggle action for smart home devices. So if I search for home, we still have the control home action and get state, but this action right here is really key. You can just choose to toggle an accessory state, choose the accessories that you actually want to toggle. Let's choose one of my studio lights so you can actually see it go on and off. Before, you had to create an if statement to get the current state of the device and then toggle it. But now, just one action, I can run this, it turned the light off, I can run it again, and it turns the light on. This will be really helpful just to create some shortcuts to toggle HomeKit accessories, and it'll be much simpler. Up next, Apple Books has a new action. I tried to cross-reference, it looks like a lot of these actions are available in earlier versions, but now you can open to a specific view in the Books app, and there should be a change view in Books if you want to put that like on the action button or a widget in the control center to change the view. It's kind of been going in and out of the betas, so just keep an eye out if you want to look for that change view in Books action. Number four, we have some great actions to actually manage our shortcuts. So if I search for shortcuts down here, you'll now see a create folder action for shortcuts. So this is not a create folder in the Files app. This will actually create a new folder here in Shortcuts. So here I'll title a new folder, run the shortcut, and now I have a new folder here in my Shortcuts app with that title. I can scroll all the way down to the bottom of my folders, and you'll see it here. And this action is even more powerful when combined with some of the other new actions. Because number five, another new action is you can add a shortcut to the home screen of your device. So I actually have another shortcut here that's Open Primary Tech, my tech podcast with Jason Aten. You should totally listen, link above and in the description. And if I expand this action, you can choose to title what gets added to the home screen and what image you want to use. So I'm actually pulling an image from the Files app. Now when I run this shortcut, it's going to create a home screen icon automatically. Before, this was a multi-step process by going into a shortcut, tapping it and add to home screen. Now if I just run this shortcut, it's going to create that icon automatically. And there it is, right there. And I can tap that shortcut, and it loads the Primary Technology website. Now, this becomes more powerful when you combine it with the Get Shortcuts action. For instance, I created this shortcut, and I'll link it down in the video description. Again, remember, you have to be running 18.1 or newer to use this, but you can get shortcuts from a specific folder. So one of the folders I have here are app icons. Maybe you like changing the app icons, and the tinting in iOS 18 is not doing it for you. Well, you can have a bunch of open app shortcuts in a folder. I'm going to get all those shortcuts, and then I'm going to repeat with each of the shortcuts in that folder the add to home screen action. So this is going to add multiple app icons to my home screen. So if I run this shortcut, I have about four shortcuts in that folder. you'll see it's going to add multiple home screen shortcuts to all those apps, and then I can use these to open specific apps and create my own custom icon pack. And the add to home screen action, if you have some images you want to use for those icons, tap and hold on the choose part of the image, and you can have it ask each time. This way it'll bring up the photo library or the files picker, and you can choose those custom images every time you run this. If you're super into making all your own icons, this little shortcut right here is going to be really useful. Number six, another new action I'm going to be using all the time is create iCloud link. So if you search for the shortcuts actions, we have our add to home screen, create folder, and this action is new right here, create iCloud link for shortcut. This is what I do in every one of my videos, and it is a very manual process. But now what I can do, my first action is going to be get my shortcuts. When you choose that action, you can have this choose a specific folder, and I'll choose the iOS 18 new folder that I'm working with in this video. Now I'll add a repeat with each action, and now put that new action, create iCloud link for shortcut, in that repeat section. This little block right here, I'll tap and hold on it, and let me choose repeat item. So what this is going to do is, previously, I had to go to the share button for every single shortcut, copy it, then put that in a note so I could put it in the video description for you guys. Well, now I can get all the shortcuts within a folder, for each shortcut, automatically generate an iCloud link. And to save me even more time, I'm gonna add a text block underneath it. And here I can choose repeat item. That'll be the title of the shortcut. You can see you can choose down here the different variables. I'll choose name. Underneath that, I'll choose the iCloud link that gets generated. And I'm gonna add a space underneath that. Finally, at the end of the repeat section, we're gonna look for a combine action. We'll combine that text with new lines, and then let's create a new note. I typically add these to bear, but we can do an Apple Notes right here. I'm going to title the note here, although you can have that ask every time. I'm going to create the note with the combined text, and I can choose a folder. I'll choose my video folder. And now when I run this shortcut, it is going to give me this prompt every time. That's a little unfortunate. I hope they change that. This way I don't have to hit share every time, but it's running through every shortcut that I have in that folder, generating the iCloud link. And once I've tapped share for all the shortcuts, I'll hit always allow, and it generated a new note with the title of each shortcut and the iCloud link that I can use in the video description, way faster than manually getting each of those links. That is a very welcome new action in iOS 18. All right, number seven, there's a new action for Safari called Switch Tab, and this will actually let you just go to a specific tab that you have open in Safari right now. So if I hit play, it'll go to a tab that I have open. It's an interesting action. I'm not exactly sure how I want to use it just yet, but this is one of the updates from Matthew Cassinelli on shortcuts for iOS 18. I'm going to come back to this, but link to this article is in the description. Number eight, we have multi-conditional if statements. This is incredibly powerful. Previously, you would have to have multiple if statements if you wanted to do things like by location and by date. For instance, maybe we want to have conditionals based on focus and location. Well, now I'll do a get current focus as the first action. I can say if current focus, I'm going to tap on where it says icon and change that to name. And if current focus is filming, which that actually is my current focus mode, then you'll see the little plus button. And now I can add a second condition to the if statement. And you'll see it also changed here at the top where you could say if any are true or if all are true. I'm going to add a get current location action to the top. This way I can use that here in the if statement. I'll choose if current location. And that second condition is if my current location is my home city, then show this alert. Otherwise, do nothing. And if I run the shortcut, I am in that focus mode and I'm in that city, so it showed that alert. If I change the city, now that condition is not true, even though I still am in my filming focus. I can run this, and you can see it didn't show the alert. Multi-conditional if statements, huge win. Number nine, when it comes to settings, it seems like this is a new action, set voice and data mode 2, but it seems a little buggy. You actually can't choose anything here for the first fields, even if I tap and hold on it. But I can tap on cellular plan, and it will show me my primary AT&T number. So I'm not quite sure what this is going to do. Maybe as we get further along in the betas, it'll start working. But nice to see another setting shortcut. And number 10, better organization for shortcuts actions. Again, this is Matthew Cassinelli's article. I will link this in the video description. But Matthew goes over how many actions are now just better organized. Like if you go to scripting, you'll actually see them broken out into sections like control flow and variables. Or if you go to device, you see those as like clipboard, notification, and network. He has all the details. I encourage you to go read his article. And when you go to that link, you should also check out Matthew's library. I'm actually a member for his website because you get access to literally thousands of shortcuts and they're all amazing. Highly recommend. So those are some of the new actions coming to iOS 18. I'll be keeping an eye out to see if any more come out in further betas. So if you want to be the first to know, subscribe to the channel, hit that like button. If you have shortcuts requests, leave comments below this video. I'm working on a bunch of requests. I've gotten lots of comments the last few videos, so stay tuned for that. Another reason to subscribe and hit that bell icon. But if you'd like to see my last request video where I built shortcuts that you specifically requested, check out this video right up here. And if you want to learn more about iOS 18 and some of the features that are coming even outside of shortcuts, did a whole video on that. You can check it out right up here. Thanks for tuning in. I'll catch you next time.